Alright, what's up YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. And yeah, so today's video, I'm gonna show you guys a few items. Actually, like just two pair of pants and one pair of shoes. First one, let's talk about the shoes. So, well, I haven't been buying a lot of like sneakers recently. I do saw something caught my eye. It's actually a pair of loafer by Camper Labs. So yeah, so Camper Labs is just like the name is pretty self-explanatory, I would say. So it's kind of like a experimental design department for Camper. So this is one called the Walden Loafer. Walden Loafer is already existing style for Camper shoes. But the Camper Lab version, what they've been doing is like they extragated the outsole, so yeah, to make it like a little bit more bulky or chunkier. When I saw this on Essence, I just immediately thinking this is really pleasant to look just for the chunkier sole. Because of all the other loafer I saw on Essence, for example from Bodega, they just like kind of like a regular penny loafer, didn't see anything special or any special design. Yeah, there are some other loafers, like for example Marnie, those are really interesting, but I don't think that fits in my style. Lastly, I found this like Camper Lab loafers. So yeah, so the whole construction is this stiff cuffing leather. After breaks in, it's actually much easier to wear right now. And the insoles, I believe they use the Ultralight insole for this one. And the overall, it's just really comfortable, really easy to wear pair of a shoe. So I'm wearing it just casually. But definitely, yeah, you can dress it up, you can dress it down. There's no limitations just for pair of shoes like this. I definitely recommending this pair. So the price on Essence is actually pretty good. I think it's like $255. But if you're buying it like on the online, like the official online store, it will be $280. So I'm not sure why, but just take advantage if you know there's a cheaper price, I would say. And for sizing, that's definitely something I want to talk about. So this pair of shoes is fit me like a small. So normally for dress shoes or like boot designer stuff, I'm wearing a 43. Initially I bought a 43 and it's just way too tight. I can wear it without socks, but still really tight. And then I got this pair of like a 44. So yeah, so I would say go up a size if you're in between size. All right, next up, we have this pair of pants from Bottega Veneta spring summer 21 season. So I don't even think this one have like official name from the website. It's just called the cotton pants. So yeah, but from the tag, it actually said, I think it said like the cotton pants, compact cotton fairly. I'm not even sure what that means, but I think it means the fabric. So the whole pants is made of like this really smooth, really soft, high quality cotton. It's actually way too soft or way too delicate. I almost think this is a whole polyester. I think right now it's pretty iconic design for the past Bottega Veneta season. So a lot of this pants featuring this like flap to covering, to hidden the top button. As well as this triangle pocket insert. So the only highlight of this pant I would consider is all the dart they did for the knee, as well as like this curved shaped leg. This give you a little bit like 3D cutting if you know what what I mean. So this is actually more, we see more of this design in techwear actually. For example, you can see a lot of like a darting if you're looking into Acronym or, you know, Pico, like things like that. So yeah, so just a really good pair of like everyday pants, I would say. Yeah, so lastly, it's just one pair of pants just caught my attention and I'm glad that I found it. So this is a pair of digital denim by Our Legacy. So the reason right now I'm wearing this pair of like the G. Sven Olten pants, it's just like they're using exactly the same technology or approach for the pants. So all the distressing or all the thing you saw right now on the screen, it's not real. It's actually printed. So that's the crazy part. And the details on this is just like amazing. Like I cannot, like when I first saw it, I cannot even, you know, distinguish, like unless I put my hands on it to feel it or like looking really, really, really close to know, oh, okay, this is actually crazy. So yeah, I was just really shocking by how good this is actually is. Another fun detail I found is really, really interesting is they kind of did a fake flared pattern here. If you see this like a line here, so this is the actual stitching line of the pants. Then this is the one they printed on. So it seems like give you, so when I wear it, it may look like it have a little bit of flare, but actually it's not. It's like 100% straight cut. So this is also happening with the inseam of the pants. So you see this kind of like a triangle flare thing going on, but it's all fake. This is the whole printed. This just blows my mind. I think this is so cool. Yeah, another thing I just thought after I, you know, start looking at this denim is that do we really need all those like distressing and washing if we can just print them on? Yeah, I mean, if you know the design, for example, the Levi's maybe never the wash, if you know what the design, you know, how, where the fade, where's the, you know, the whiskers going on, you can definitely just print them all and it will look like almost identical. Definitely can fool people around, I would say. So I'm just gonna like slowly hovering off the screen to make you guys see all the details here. So yeah, as you can see, this is actually a real rivet and this is like a fake one. Yeah, the distressing detail, I would say just like I can't even get started. They definitely picked the correct reference. Like I'm not complaining at all for any distressing to have on these pants. See this bottom? Yeah. So and lastly, they featured this pretty interesting transparent back tab. Yeah, I'm just so hyped for this pair now. And I know they're gonna have like a new pair coming out for a black and white color, not indigo denim. They have like a black denim for the also full printed. I already see it in the lookbook. So yeah, if you guess, it will be really, really hard to find this pair exactly, but you definitely can keep an eye out for the new drop coming in. So for the price of this pair, it's a little bit steep, I would say. So retail price is like 400 euro. From what I've been seeing, it's definitely worth it for the price. Just comparing this pair versus one, the Drisman Open one I'm wearing right now, the details on this one is much better. Just you know, how realistic, like how vivid those distressing are. Yeah, I have to definitely put my money on this one 100%. Yep, that's everything I got for this video. So, hope you guys enjoy the content, and see you guys next one. Peace out.